Hello everyone, I am Dr. Yojana Munnu, Assistant Professor in Zoology, and today we are going to discuss about movement and locomotion, in which we are going to study about the structure of striated muscle fiber. So before going to the structure of striated muscle fiber, we are going to see the basics about the movements and locomotion. So let's start with the definition. Movement may be described as a change in position of any part of the organism body. It involves motion of a part organ of the body. The movement results in change in locomotion is called as locomotion. Locomotion is defined as the ability of body to move from one place to another. For example, we are walking, moving, we are jumping, crawling, crawling, etc. Locomotion is very important feature of animals. It helps them to go in search of food, shelter, mate, etc. Movement can be at organism level, tissue level, as well as cell level. For example, cell moves from one place to another at the time of embryo formation. Whereas locomotion is termed as movement of a body from one axis to another or many in terms of coordinates. It has to be noted that movement of cell from one place to another cannot be considered as a locomotion. It is only the movement. And the movement on one hand can be voluntary or involuntary, whereas locomotion is always voluntary in nature. Voluntary means it is under the control of your will. But involuntary is not your under of the control of the will. It is under the control of your nervous system. So we'll see about the types of movement. There are about four types of movement, in which the first one is the amoeboid movement. This movement takes place in the phagocytes, where leukocytes and macrophages migrate through the tissue. It is affected by pseudopodia formed by the streaming of protoplasm, as in amoeba. So in the cell, in the unicellular organism, they are having a cytoplasm, and that cytoplasm will move from one place to another within that cell body. And wherever the cytoplasm will move, there that pseudopodia will form, and that wherever the pseudopodia will form, at that location, at that direction, that amoeba or that cell will move. Next one is the flagellated movement. This movement takes place with the help of the flagella. For example, in case of Euglena, flagella is the tail-like structure which helps them for the movement. Next one is the ciliary movement. These movements occurs with the help of the cilia. For example, in case of the paramecium, paramecium is covered with the lining which is having a number of cilia, and beating of the cilia or the movement of the cilia will help them for the locomotion. And next one is the muscular movement. This movement involves the muscle fibers which have the ability to contract and relax. And by this contraction of these muscles, our body can move. So we'll see about the types of the muscle tissue. So our body is made up of the cell, and cells come together to form the tissue. So all the organs which are present in our body, it is not made up of the same type of the muscles. Different kinds of the muscles are present in our body. So three types of the muscles present in our body which forms the different organ and system. So the first one is the smooth muscle fiber. Smooth muscle fiber or the smooth muscle cells, also called as the visceral muscle fiber. So why it is called as the visceral muscle? Because it is related with the visceral tissues or the visceral organs present in your body. Second one is the cardiac muscle cells. Cardiac muscle cells, as the name indicates, cardiac means it's related with the heart. Means these are present in your heart. And the next one is the striated muscle fiber. Striated muscle fiber, also known as the skeleton muscle fiber, because it is related with your skeleton system. So first we'll see what is the difference between these three one. So the first one is the striated muscle fiber. Striated muscle fiber, why it is called as striated muscle fiber? Because when you see it under the simple microscope, it will show that alternate dark and light band. Dark bands are made up of the myosin, and the light band is made up of the actin. And these actin and myosin are actually the proteins which help for the contraction of the muscles. They are also called as the skeletal muscles because they are related with your skeletal system. And they are also called as the voluntary muscles because they are under your control of your will. Second one is the smooth muscle fiber. Smooth muscle fiber, as I told you, it is also called as the visceral muscle fiber because it is related with your visceral organs. In case of striated muscle fibers, they are multinucleated, means having a many nucleus which is present at the periphery. But in case of smooth muscle fiber, they are spindle shaped one, and they are having only single nucleus. The last one is the cardiac muscle tissue or the cardiac muscle fiber, which is showing the characteristics of both, characteristics of skeletal muscle also and characteristics of the smooth muscles also. So what are the characteristics are similar to the skeletal muscles? Like the skeletal muscles, they also shows the alternate light and dark band. And like the smooth muscles, they are having only a single nucleus. Only difference is that they are branched one. The cardiac muscles are branched, while the skeletal muscles and the smooth muscles are unbranched one. And when we see about there, they are involuntary in action, means they are under the control of the nervous system. They are not voluntary one. Now we'll see the structure of skeletal muscle, which is also called as striated muscles and the voluntary muscles. So this is the muscles present in your body, which is attached to your bone with the help of the tendon. And when we take a small part of this muscle, it will looks like this muscle. Many muscle fibers will come together, which are called as the myocytes. And these myocytes come form the bundle, which will form the muscles. And when we take the tears of this muscle, then it will looks like this, which shows the alternate dark and the light band. So in detail, we'll see the structure. So this muscle fiber is made up of the sarcomere. Sarcomere is nothing but a single muscle cell. So these many single muscle cells arrange horizontally to form a long muscle fiber. So this is differentiated by this Z disc, which you can see over here. So this is the actually boundary of the sarcomere. Sarcomere means the muscle cell, a single muscle cell. So this Z disc to Z disc, this is the one sarcomere. So when the cell changes, cells are having a cell organelles, and as the cell changes, their names also changes. So in case of cell, when the cytoplasm is present, we call it as a cytoplasm, but in case of muscle fiber, we call it as a sarcolemma. The endoplasmic reticulum is also present in a muscle cell, which is called as the sarcoplasmic reticulum. And what is the role of the sarcoplasmic reticulum? That we know that for the moment we will need the calcium, and sarcoplasmic reticulum is nothing but the storage house of the calcium. They also consist of the nucleus. As I said, these muscle fibers, skeletal muscle fibers, they are multicellular, and multicellular means they are present, many cells are present, and the many nucleus are present, and nucleus which are present, they are present at the periphery towards the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane means the membrane of this cell, muscle cell. So this muscle cell is also having a plasma membrane. Towards the plasma membrane, the nucleus are present, which are multinucleated one. Now as I said, the actin and myosin, these are the two important proteins which help into the contraction. So what are these actin and myosin, how they are present? So we have seen that when we see it under the simple microscope, it will show the alternate light and dark band. This dark band is made up of the myosin and light band is made up of actin. So here you can observe this red colored line, which is attached to the Z line, to this Z disc. So it is present at both the side. So this actin will form the light band, and this red colored, which you can observe, this is a myosin, which is forms the dark band. So this light band is called as the I band. Here you can observe it is called as the I band. I band, I stands for isotropic. So actin is present at both the side. So this complete actin is known as the I band, and this red colored complete myosin is called as the dark band. Again, you can observe this red colored myosin, it is present in between this actin, means they are overlapping in between the actin. So this overlapping part, this complete myosin is known as the A band. But you can observe there is some part which is not overlapping with the actin, and this part is called as the H zone. So this myosin, they are hold together by the M line. Here you can observe this is the M line, which actually hold this myosin together. So how the movement will takes place? The movement will takes place by the sliding filament theory, where this actin and myosin, they will come close to each other and contraction will takes place. So about this sliding filament theory, we will see to the in the next video. Thank you.